Hello, Al Pals. This is Big Al. Welcome to Big Al Presents another Christmas movie review. That's right. The Christmas season is in full swing, and I have seen another Christmas film that I wanted to share some thoughts on. Violent Night. I remember when I first saw the trailer for this film, I was in. I wanted to see it very much. I'm a fan of David Harbour, of course, because I love Stranger Things, and I just like the concept. So I finally got a chance to see it. Did it live up to my expectations? Well, before I tell you that, caution, maybe some spoilers ahead. Not too many, but just in case. So if you don't want to know anything, you might want to stop here and come back later. Now that that's out of the way, Violent Night. Santa Claus, played by David Harbour, is taking a short break at a bar, drinking heavily and bemoaning the lack of Christmas spirit, and wondering if there's still a place for him in this world. Santa visits a house and finds it under siege by mercenaries looking to steal over $300 million in the family vault. Finding himself abandoned by the reindeer, Santa uses one of the mercenaries' walkie-talkie to contact Trudy, played by Lea Brady, a young girl hiding in the attic, and discovers she's on his nice list. So Santa channels his days as a Viking over 1,000 years ago and begins to take matters into his own hands. Now, I know many people are going to criticize showing Santa committing such acts of ultra-violence, but if you could suspend disbelief and tap into the joy people have watching such films as Die Hard at this time of year, then Violent Night can itself become a true Christmas comedy action classic. David Harbour is not the first person one would consider casting as Santa Claus, but having seen Violent Night, he proved an inspired choice for the role. Harbour was terrific and maybe one of the best film Santas ever, joining Edmund Gwenn and Tim Allen. Even excluding the ultra-violent action content, David Harbour's comedic timing is impeccable, and he also has this glint in his eyes and exhibits a sweetness and elfish quality that is perfect for the role. John Leguizamo is extremely intense as the villainous leader of the mercenaries, codenamed Mr. Scrooge, and credit to the writers for including a backstory that explains why he has such a grudge against anything Christmas. Beverly D'Angelo also appears as Gertrude Lightstone, the delightfully coarse matriarch of the family being held at gunpoint, and it's quite a nice departure from her role on Christmas Vacation. This is kind of nice seeing her in, as such a foul-mouthed woman. It was quite a treat. Violent Night is unquestionably not going to be a film for everyone. But if you are one of those who believe that Die Hard is a Christmas movie, though I disagree, Violent Night may definitely find a place in your yearly viewing. I mean, this is what a real Christmas movie with violence is. No disrespect to Die Hard fans, but my opinion stands. The film boasts consistent direction and features fantastic action sequences with inventive Christmassy ways to kill. Despite a number of mercenaries with funny Christmas code names and a family of questionable priorities and morals, it also displays an amazing sense of humor with some warm and fuzzy moments, like Santa regaining his joy of Christmas and a family coming back together. Violent Night is a well-written and wonderfully acted action comedy film with a surprisingly joyful Christmas feel. David Harbour's huge presence lifts Violent Night above what it could have easily become. The crazy, violent Christmas mockery. But thanks to him, a wonderful cast, and some clever writing, Violent Night could find itself becoming another Christmas classic. So, what am I giving it? 4 stars out of 5. I really enjoyed this film. I almost went 4.5, but there are enough issues here and there that kind of, you know, whatever. But it's they're so minor, it's not even worth mentioning. The film is just enjoyable. David Harbour has a great charisma. I like him in almost everything I see him in, and it's just a great choice for a Santa Claus that I never thought of. And he brings it in this film. Even outside of the violence, like I said, he just has a great Santa quality to him. And I would love to see Violent Night 2. But I don't know if they're going to do it, but I could definitely see him playing the role again. Even if, you know, to kind of flesh out the character. They introduced a few interesting bat stories for him. He used to be a Viking. I would love to see a little bit more about that and how he became Santa Claus. They don't really go that much in depth with it. They do tell us there is a Mrs. Claus. The reindeer, kind of, he has a little contentious relationship with the reindeer, which is kind of funny. But like I said, it's got a great sense of humor. The action is solid. Yes, it is ultra violent, and some people may take issue with Santa Claus being so deadly, basically. And I get it. I understand it. Like I said, if you have that issue at all, don't watch it, because you know it's just not going to be for you. But if you can suspend that disbelief, and if you just like a solid action film with some humor, some fun performances, and if you just can buy that Santa Claus does some really interesting things with a sledgehammer and a candy cane, I won't get into any more about that, then I think you'd really definitely like this film. Like I said, 4 stars. I really enjoyed it. Definitely something I could watch myself watching several more times just for fun. But just, you know, top to bottom, it's just a good, solid Christmas action comedy that I didn't know I wanted in my life, and thank God I've got it. Well, that is my review for Violent Night. I hope that if you haven't subscribed to my channel, Big Al Presents, that you do so. More reviews, rewatches, and rambles in weeks and months to come. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I would really be appreciative. And share it. Get the word out there. If you know people that like a good solid action film with lots of stabbings and beatings and explosions, not a lot of explosions, but there are a few, then this is definitely a fun film for them. But whatever you are watching, whether it is Violent Night or Die Hard or some other Christmas film, I'm not going to fight people on the Die Hard is a Christmas movie thing. My opinion is well known. Whatever you love, watch it. That is the whole point of it. Hope everyone is having a wonderful Christmas season. Take care, and until next time, goodbye.